would a Thursday be without a Green Thumb Thursday and my boyfriend, Justin Rohner?
It's beautiful.
Yes, the founder of Agriscaping Technologies is here today because we're going to talk about the three things you need to know and what you need to plant this fall. And the one thing I love that's on there, edibles, edible
That's right.
flowers, yeah.
The top three things to plant this fall. This is absolutely Arizona's best time to plant, so don't miss it.
Yes.
Don't miss this amazing weather.
The weather's fantastic and it's great, and you've got some wonderful things. We're going to talk about the three F's today: food, flowers, and fun.
Food, flowers,
yeah,
and fun. So
yeah,
on the food side, obviously, we got a nice menagerie of wonderful things that you can grow
in the garden this time of
year. Look at
Justin throwing out the big words, menagerie.
It's wonderful stuff. All your salad greens can get growing in the ground right now, your kales, your lettuces, your broccolis. You can start throwing the seeds in the ground right now. It's a great time to be doing that, especially before a little rain that we're going to be having this weekend.
Yeah, it's going to be good. You also got some roots down here. Is this ginger?
That is ginger, and the plant actually looks like that. So a lot of the tropicals, we love growing them in the early part of the month. So this is actually some guava. A nice sweet white guava. The Vietnamese have some of the best white guavas out there. You want to find some good varieties of that. The bees are even starting to come in.
I know,
in the
they love
well.
It. They're just as happy as we are.
Pineapple.
This is, good.
This is another one, a good tropical that you can grow, but hard to find. This is called miracle fruit.
Miracle fruit.
Miracle fruit.
Why it makes is it hard to find?
Better. Because it is a rare plant, and it's it's definitely grow more as an indoor plant here. We're going to put this actually in a beautiful atrium here in Scottsdale, and so we're looking forward to growing this. And it's an amazing fruit. Look it up.
Okay.
You know, miracle fruit. It's something that will change the flavor of a lemon. You can eat a lemon, the whole rind and all, after eating one of these, and it'll taste like lemonade.
Oh, that's
it'll
interesting.
It'll change your taste buds. It's amazing.
We like that.
So
all
food.
Right. Food is the first thing, and now we're moving on to the flowers, which I love because they're all edible, and you can put these in your salad, and it makes a little, colorful decor, but it also gives you something different in flavor.
Yeah, adds a lot of pop to your garden and also to your salad. So we got begonias. Make sure you get a good source for those begonias. A lot of the varieties of edible flowers, things that are edible, you want to just be careful on the source that they're not using systemic pesticides and other things that they put inside the different types of herbicides and other things. You just want to make sure that you're getting a plant that has been naturally grown and is growing with the kind of stuff that you would actually eat yourself. So orchids are also an edible flower.
This is beautiful though. So who would want to eat this? But I mean, you can, but it's actually beautiful.
So hopefully you get one with enough abundant flower growth that you can throw it on a salad at, use it as a garnish. A lot of people also don't know that these flowers down here, the pansies, the violas, and the alyssum are also all edible. And so you can throw these in the garden. They're great throughout the winter months. They'll go all the way through April if you got it in the right spot.
Nice.
May if you put it in a nice A microclimate. So some more fun. I mean, this is all about fun too.
It's like
being
it's
able
always
to add
fun.
Some fun.
Yeah.
Variegated varieties of things. So these are sages. They've got bicolor. Ooh. There's purple sages. Beautiful plants that'll last for a very long time. They can act as a nice perennial in your garden. Another great one is bananas.
Bananas, yes, bananas.
This one right here is a Puerto Rican dwarf red banana.
Their leaves are gorgeous.
Oh, they're amazing. And we just love growing these in the garden. These need a nice C microclimate is our best place to put them, a B or a C. If you want to know more about that, go to greenthumbthursday.com.
Greenthumbthursday.com, which is the new website.
You'll be
intrigued once you get there, too, because there's so much stuff. Again, it's Justin Rohner of Agriscaping Technologies. Agriscaping.com is the other website as well. We'll have a link on our website, too, azdailymix.com. Justin, you're always fantastic.
Oh, it's wonderful to be here with you.